It's an easy to medium difficulty question. I'll classify this one as a GMAT 650 level problem solving question from number properties and sequences in series, specifically arithmetic progression. We'll solve this question in two ways. The first one is a textbook approach, reasonably easy one, should get us the answer in about a minute or so. The second one is looking at the question a little differently. Many times when you look at it differently, you get a perspective which is a little more interesting than the traditional textbook approach. We'll solve both these methods in this video. Set A contains all the even numbers between 2 and 50, both inclusive. So we're going to start with 2, go all the way up to 50, count only even numbers. Set B contains all the even numbers between 102 and 150, both inclusive. What is the difference between the sum of elements of set A and that of set B? We're going to count, find the sum of elements in this set, find the sum of elements in this set, and we need to find out the difference between the two. That's what this question is about. Irrespective of the method, let's first get clarity about what elements does set A have and what elements does set B have. Set A has the following elements: 2, 4, 6, 8, all the way up to 50. Even numbers up to 50. Set B starts with 102, has even numbers, goes all the way up to 150. We'll find how many elements are there in set A. If it just went up to 10, for instance, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, there are 5 elements. In the first 10 numbers, where there are 10 numbers, we are counting only the even numbers, we are not counting the odd numbers. So we're leaving out one half of the numbers. So we went from 2 to 10, we'll have a count of 5 numbers in the set. We are going from 2 to 50 and counting only the even numbers. So set A will have 25 elements. So is set B, because it's going to start with 102, it's displaced by 100 actually, and goes all the way up to 150. So set B will also have 25 elements. Set A has 25 elements, set B has 25 elements. Method 1 is a straightforward textbook approach. We're going to do exactly what the question is asking us to do. It's asking us to find out the difference between the sum of elements of set B and set A. So we'll find out the sum of elements of set B, then we'll find out sum of elements of set A, and then compute the difference. That's a textbook approach. How do we find out sum of elements of an arithmetic progression? These sets are in arithmetic progression for the simple reason the difference between any two elements in both these sets is the same, which is equal to 2. So these set A and set B, both these sets are in an AP. Sum of an AP is n by 2, where n is a number of elements in the set, into first term plus last term. So let's find out sum for set B. We'll call it as SB. How many elements are there? There are 25. So 25 by 2. The first element of set B is 102. The last element of set B is 150. 150 plus 102 is 252 divided by 2 is a 126. So this is 25 times 126. 25 times 126. 25 into 120. 25 times 120 is a 3000 plus 150. So this number is 3150. So you compute it, sum of elements of set B. Let's just repeat this process for set A. Number of elements is the same, 25. The first element of the set is a 2. The last element is a 50. So 2 plus 50 is a 52. We'll cancel with 2 to leave us with a 26. 25 times 26. 25 times 26 is equal to 650. We found out the sum of both these sets. Let's compute the difference. This equals 2500. Very straightforward, simple. There's no gimmicks at all in this. This method will give us an answer probably in a minute or 75 seconds, not more than that, right? So done, we got the answer. Whatever is the answer choice, I think choice E is the answer. We have finished this method. Let's keep this aside. It's a textbook method. Good, you could have got the answer this way. Absolutely perfect. Let's look at, can we look at it a little differently? Some cases, these throw open our mind to looking at things differently. Let's do that here. In method 2, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do it a little differently. I'm not going to compute the sum and then the difference. Here, I'm going to compute the difference between, I'm calling them as corresponding elements of both the sets. And then I'm going to add all the differences. What do I mean by that? I'm going to pick one element from set A. I'm going to pick what I call as a corresponding pair from set B. Both these sets, let's say we are writing them in ascending order. 2, 4, 6, 8, excuse me, all the way up to 50. Set B, 102, 104, 106, all the way up to 150. If I pick the first element from set A, right? I'm picking the first element from set A, which is a 2. The first element from set B, that's a corresponding element, is what I call. The difference between these two equals 100. Let's pick the second element. Second element of set A is a 4. Corresponding element here is 104. The difference is 100. Let's go to the fifth element. We'll just skip few of them. The fifth element is going to be a 10. In this case, it's going to be 110. The difference continues to be 100. You just skip all of them. Go to the last element of set A. Last element of set A equals 50. The last element of set B equals 150. The difference equals 100. In method 1, what did we do? We basically added the first element, second element, added all of this up to the 50th element, found the sum for this. This worked out to 650. And then correspondingly found out the sum for set B, which worked out to 3150, and found out the difference. In method 2, what we are doing is, we are not adding these initially and finding the difference. We are computing the difference between the second column and first column, found it to be 100. We are adding all the differences, which should also work out to be the same answer. The difference between an element of set A and its corresponding element in set B is 100. How many such elements do we have in each of these sets? We know there are 25 elements in each set. So 25 times the difference between each pair, which is 100. So the answer equals 2500. If you went about it this way, we know the answer here is 650. The answer here is 3150. The difference was 2500, which is what we computed in method 1. Second method, we're computing the differences. Each element of set A and its corresponding an element in set B, the difference is 100. How many such pairs will you be able to find? 25 such pairs. The sum equals 2500. Right? So what we have done in a printed form, pick the first element in set B, subtracted the first element in set A. So these corresponding differences are 100. Add all the differences, you'll get an answer which is equal to 2500. Choice E is the correct answer to the question. Before you leave, three things. One, sign up as a trial user at wzko.in/core. Get started with statistics and average. It's a free topic. Build momentum into your GMAT preparation with this topic. And then convert it into a paid user and unlock the remaining topics. Two other things. One, subscribe to this channel, youtube.com/vizako. And the third thing, not only can you subscribe to the channel, you can also do one more thing. You can join as a member of this channel. If you join as a member of this channel for a small monthly fee, you'll be able to get member-only perks which are not available to free users. These member-only perks will help give you a boost to your GMAT preparation. Click on the join button. You'll have a listing of the member-only perks, and that would help you crack the GMAT. Best wishes.